Joining me around the table, Penny Lee. She's a Democratic strategist and former advisor to Senator Harry Reid. Corey Dade, NPR contributor and writer of The Take, a political blog at The Root. And Alex Castellanos, a CNN commentator and Republican consultant. Can I just start with, if you've got an oversight committee that can't get bureaucrats to come talk to you, like, does that sort of smack of a bureaucracy that's just gone rogue?
Yeah, it's about the worst time that they need to be holding back, you know, especially the VA. I mean, this is a moment when they need to be as assertive and transparent as possible.
I think that's the place to focus. You know, it's easy to blame President Obama now because all of a sudden he's shocked to find he's ignored the VA for 5 years, and I'm sure he's going to give himself a very stern talking to here. But the truth is, Democrats have tried to fix this and haven't. Republicans have tried to fix this and haven't. Veterans themselves, Shinseki, whom we know care about this, have tried to fix this and haven't. Maybe they haven't because they can't. This is an old top-down Washington bureaucratic system. Imagine that we built a factory to fix your health care. Right now, to give you health care. Your health care is intimate, personal, different than anybody else's. But a big old Washington bureaucracy trying to take care of that, guess what? It just does not work. The answer.
This sounds like the Republican approach to government health care.
And it matters because it is. By the way, Paul Krugman has said, welcome to socialized medicine. This is the VA. And by the way, it works great. Well, guess what?
It may not work great, but apparently the health care is good if you can get in. That's the problem.
Yeah, that's the problem. Access. It has always been touted, even when we were going through the health care debate, was look at the VA model, is that so many of the veterans, once they get the care, it's very specialized and it's very much geared towards what their specific injuries are. As the senator was saying earlier, you know, look, we've had 2 million more people into the system than we've ever had before. I think it's time that we re-examine the model. Because the model, I think, is what is broken, and we need to hold those that are in charge accountable for that.
Let me take just a bit of exception, though. 2 million more people? This has been going on for decades. This has been going on forever. Again, this is the more complex something is, the less politicians and bureaucrats can serve you well.
Yeah, but I don't think this is argument for.
Yes, it is. Let's open up health care.
I'm going to let you get a sentence out here.
Well, I do think we need to look at the president's response here in part. You know, this is a president who, as a senator, was on the Veteran Affairs Committee. He even criticized the Bush administration for its inability to bring reforms.
Set those expectations way up here.
And so he campaigned again for re-election on making veterans priority in his administration. So here he is coming out. When he comes out, he waits 3 weeks. And then when he comes out, he says, if these allegations are true, that is not the kind of optic that he wants right now.
And while we're on the subject of optics, we did have his news conference where he talked about, right. Well, I just want to wait. And we did have him announce a new housing secretary and et cetera, et cetera. But I want to show you the other part of his week. He was headed over to the interior and he took a stroll on the mall and said hey to tourists. And then he went to Cooperstown. Right, to the Baseball Hall of Fame, where he talked about tourism and looked at the museum. And then he went up to Chicago to fundraise and stopped by a hometown eatery that he really loves and goes to. Camera's there, too. So talk to me about optics.
I would just say that just because the president might not have it every single day of every single speech in addressing this, that's not to say that the work isn't being done. And he is one that has shown that, look, he's going to allow his managers to get back and say what is at the stake so that he can put together the right plan to put to it. We've seen this before in many of the other crises that they've had.
I don't think it's one or the other. I don't think it's that he has to show that he has his hand on the button. He is at it, and at the same time can't do sort of the politicking that he needs to do. This is a president whose campaign, you know, is done, but he needs a campaign for his party. He needs to get his numbers up. So doing these kinds of tours, that's normal. He needs to be doing it.
Exactly, but I just wonder we even saw Democrats complain about Hello, could you go to a VA someplace and do something? Now, look, I know it's PR. I know it's all those things, and the president can do all kinds of things while appearing to be touring. But the fact is, at some point, does no drama Obama become a drawback?
Oh, absolutely.
Very much so. And, you know, I hate to be in the position of defending Barack Obama here. I think
okay,
the problem is bigger than any one man or party right now. I think it is the system. But when your house is on fire, you don't want the firemen going to Cooperstown. This is a national crisis. It is a crisis about the people we say we value the most. And what do we know about this president? Very bright man, cerebral man, lives in his head, and gets bored sometimes with the mundane trivia of actually having to make things work and get things done. Valerie Jarrett has said he's bored as president as time. You know what? Like most of us, our strength is our weakness. His strength is he's a man of ideas. His weakness
but
is the
but
same
Alex,
thing.
I have to disagree with you on that. When things come about, I mean, when you saw this,
like Obama
deep oil, when the oil crisis was happening in the Gulf, he went because there was a mismanagement. They hadn't inspected these in for 4 or 5 years. So he sent his team in, and now that whole system has changed, so that can be prevented going into the future. So when he has an issue at hand, he goes in, he solves it, he puts the right team in place. It is a big bureaucracy, as we have all acknowledged, and he can't have his finger in every single pot.
Yeah,
but
the
when
time,
the crisis occurs, he is able to go in there and strategically and surgically go
often,
in and fix these issues, which is what he will do for
it's
the VA.
It's often when he responds to these crises. The BP oil spill, I covered it, I was there. One of the problems was he came out late. He came out, he tends to come out right when something gets to become a big crisis or public embarrassment. Now, when he actually executes, he has done an excellent job in executing. He's certainly not someone who likes to give in to the fanfare, and he resists the calls of the dogs to fire his people and that kind of stuff.
There's
certainly loyalty, but he needs to pay attention to the optics.
You've got
be a little bit more
10
assertive.
Seconds, yeah.
He's not a man of action. He's reticent to take action. He likes to think first. He draws red lines and then reconsiders. That's Barack Obama.
Yeah. I'll have you back. You get a comeback, Penny Lee. Thank you so much.